All right, guys, so I haven't used enough gas yet to do that fuel pump, but I want to. I'm gonna just experiment with a little kit I got, a really cheap kit. It supposedly isn't even that good, but I'm gonna see if it works. I'm gonna try and suck out some gas out of here. I think I'm at under three quarter a tank or something. Let's see here. Yeah, I'm just under three quarters, so I'm gonna see if I can pull out and get it to about half. Then I can probably go ahead with that fuel pump job again. All right, I'll take a whirl at it. Got the gas cap off. Oh, let's see. Oh, this thing has a little thing too. Okay. So, I'm trying to remember what they said. This is the top. This is the top. So you kind of pump it. Oh, you squeeze it like that. Okay. Let me see if I squeeze it and suck. I think so. Hopefully this doesn't get stuck in my tank. It's kind of, I know it's a tiny, tiny hole too. It's not really that good. But I'll see. I'll see if it'll work. That's got to be in there pretty good. Pretty good. Put this in here just in case it starts dribbling. Let's see, what do you do? Let me see if I can. And this is sealed tight. This may not even be in the gas yet. I hear something. Getting a suction. Suck, suck, suck. Maybe I'm just blowing. Maybe it's not even in there, right? Let me double check that this is the right way around, too. Let me double check my paperwork. All right, I learned something else. It said plug. Plug the other hole to create, like, better suction. Still nothing. Alright guys, I guess you were just watching the siphoning video, which was a miserable fail. So I've just been out on like a 45 minute drive trying to use up gas. And I blew something up, just a pipe, no big deal. I blew up something on the drive on the way back under a really hard acceleration, full throttle, shifted real quick, and the pop-off valve. And I went, that's the loudest pop-off I've ever heard. And I went, wait a minute. And I stepped on the car, and it just fell on its face. Oh, no. First thing you always check is your top connection boost pipe. That was fine, super solid. I'm pretty sure the problem is my lower boost pipe. You can't really see it, can you? Ugh. I think it's that lower boost pipe down there. It looks like the clamp is off of the hose, and I didn't push it far enough into the lower down there. I don't even know if you can see it on camera, but I have to look at that lower charge pipe connection now and get it back so I'm not scared as hell. Then I can move on to the fuel pump job as long as I find the issue and I feel better about it. Yep, guys, that was it. The entire pipe is off, so I gotta fix that. Whew, I'm just glad that's all it is. Just to help you guys learn from it. So I had this pipe like butting up against the grim speed here. So I had a whole inch really to play with. So now let's see, right, that's the soft spot. So right here, so I basically got an inch of the pipe back out to fill me in down there. Now it's gonna be so hard to do that clamp. I can probably do it as is. I don't think I need to take apart everything. But now this lower is in like a half inch or more deeper, and I already thought it was good, so for sure it'll be good next, and I'll just put the clamp back on it. I'm just glad it wasn't a PC, a BPV thing or anything. I'm sure all that looks okay. So, whew. Got lucky this time. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to take off this Perrin clamp, which isn't my favorite. It's too thin. And I'm going to go with my Breeze, which is a lot thicker and, in my opinion, stronger. And I think I have a much deeper grip. It's kind of hard to tell down there, but I can't really push it down anymore, so it should be okay. But I'm going to switch the clamp up. All right, guys, so I'm going to do this. As you can see, I'm going to use my 40, my 44, my number 44 Breeze. And you can see, I mean, the difference right there. Much stronger, and it is stronger, too. It's thicker metal, more higher gauge, and much thicker, which is a lot better grip. So I'm just going to say I don't love the thinness of the Perrin clamps for an application like this. And I'm putting on these Super Breeze clamps. These are sleeve clamps, which have the protection sleeve in there, so you don't be cutting into your pipe with all these ridges. These are expensive clamps, like probably $3 a pop, and I got a collection. These are all you should use if you don't want to be cutting your hoses. Okay, guys, I actually spent like 15 minutes just looking over all my hoses. So keep a close eye on your coolant hose coming out of the bottom of the pipe, that it's not resting on the top of this thing. So I kind of pulled it over a little bit without trying to stretch anything too much. And I personally like the... Good thing I didn't spill anything. I like this protector hose, this braided, above this instead of under it. When it's under it, the charge, see, if it's under it, it's going to be behind the charge pipe, right? And when it's pushed this way, it's kind of crimping this 90 degree right here. Get out of the way, this stupid light. Oh, maybe that's better. When this pipe goes behind the charge pipe instead of above it, it pushes this 90 way tight, and I don't really like it. So instead, I just decided to route this outside of the charge pipe and then down into its channel down there. And I'm going to try tightening all this, see where I got it. Oh, I marked my charge pipe at about 1 inch for that yellow. Can you see the yellow or not? 1 inch for the yellow mark. So I'll show you right there. Okay, so then I wiggle it one-handed. It's kind of hard. I push it in, so I know that's about 1 inch right there, which is enough. And then sometimes I go like an extra eighth of an inch in there. And then if my thick clamp, the improved one, is right here, it's going to have a lot of bite, a lot more grip, and I think that'll do it. Then I'm still okay here with the coolant hose a little bit. I don't know, the coolant hose. It's kind of tricky, that coolant hose, on the best place to really put it. But I did also rotate this clamp upwards because it would have been over here touching it a little bit. I'm not sure. It's a little tight, but I mean, it would be much tighter with the Grimspeed pipe, charge pipe right there. Remember, thank God this thing is smaller here. It's already tight. Now, this is a good example of why the PYI clamp jackets that I reviewed earlier are pretty important. So you can see down here, maybe you can see, you have this metal right next to that pipe. So I'm going to put a jacket on it just for backup. I don't want to cut it because it'll be even sharper. So a jacket would probably do it, just in case it ever touches anything there. I don't know if you can see this with a good light or not. All right, guys, well, you know me. 30 minutes later, and I'm still fine-tuning my hoses. I'm just putting it back together now. I'm all done. Had to worry about all kinds of stuff by the fans, coolant hoses resting on metal pieces that I hadn't seen before. Got a lot of ties in all specific places to keep everything real tight. So I'm finally ready to put everything back together and close the hood. Now, I don't think I needed to whatsoever, but just for peace of mind, because a few people said it, I'm just, I guess, burping the system. I just have it warmed up. It wasn't low whatsoever, so I'm just, I gotta be careful here, squeezing the hose a little bit. There's really no air that I can find in it. Even when I squeeze these ones far away, I get a little movement, so it is attached, you know. And let me squeeze the bottom AOS one. And again, you see a little activity, but no air bubbles. I told you nothing. Of course, yeah, you're right. The AOS did have to fill up that tiny tube, so that's a tiny bit. But remember when I did the job, remember I don't know if that was on camera, I put in like a splash, like maybe a quarter cup in like your glass measuring cup only, and that was like almost too much. So that's exactly what that would take. So I don't think there's any issues here. I'm gonna have to put the lid on this pretty soon or it's gonna start overflowing. And I think we're good. And you guys can tell me later if I'm not burping it right, and I'd be happy to do it the right way, but I think that's all you do to burp it. My heater is on, so all the passages are open. It's just about warmed up, so the thermostat is also open. So I think that's it.